Learning programming is like learning any other skill, such as learning how to cook or learning how to swim. You don't need to have a computer science background or a computer science degree if you want to start learning programming. Let's say you are from Bachelor of Commerce or Bachelor of Arts or biomedical background and you want to start learning how to code. The major challenge that people face most of the time is there are so many online resources, so many programming tutorials, and it's easy to get confused. In this video, I'm going to show you a step-by-step approach on how you can approach programming so that you can spend minimum amount of time and get the maximum output out of it. Also, I will go over many online free resources in this video which you can use to learn yourself programming. This is something you can do on your own by watching those tutorials and following those online courses and practicing the problems on your own. Step number one is to understand the principles of effective learning. I'm going to show you a video by Nishant Kasibatla who talks about how you can learn anything very effectively. I have this video link in the video description below. But if you don't want to watch that video, I will just quickly summarize what he means to say. Here is the slide that I have taken from his presentation. What he says is basically when you learn something, there are two aspects. One is input and the other one is output. In the input, you are watching programming tutorials, you are reading coding books and all of that. And in the output part, you are practicing how to code. You are also reflecting on whatever you have learned. And then you also want to share with others whatever you have learned, because they say the best way of learning something is to start teaching. The issue is majority of the time people spend a lot of time in input, which is watching so many coding tutorials online. But they don't spend much time in practicing those coding problems and exercises and even reflecting on whatever they have learned. So we need to fix this balance. We need to spend more time in output than input, which is you watch a programming tutorial, then you spend more time on reflecting whatever you have learned and then practice coding problems. Practice is the most important thing. And also then share with your friends and try to help your friends in the problem that they are facing. Once you have understood the principles of effective learning, step number two is to understand what is code. For that also, I have a nice video, so please go watch it. Again, video description has all the links that I'm going to talk about during this video. Code is basically a language that you use to communicate with a computer. When you want to communicate with any human being, you use a human language such as English, Hindi or Urdu. Similarly, to work with a computer, we use programming language such as Python, Java, JavaScript, etc. Anyways, in that video, I have more information. So now, let's say you have understood what is the code. The third step is to understand computer science principles. The program that you run, it uses CPU, RAM, input-output device, different components on the computer. Also, the data is stored in a binary format, in bits, ones and zeros. So it's important that you understand all these underlying computer science principles. For this, we have a nice Khan Academy course explaining you the computer science principles. Khan Academy is totally free. You don't have to pay anything. So please go and finish that course. This course will be applicable no matter what programming language you are trying to learn. Step number four after you have finished going through the computer science principle is to choose a career track. Being a programmer is more like being a doctor, where you have different specializations such as lung doctor, heart doctor, anesthesiologist. Similarly, in programming, you can become either a web developer, mobile developer, backend developer, data science, etc. So you have to choose a particular track that you are interested in. If you decide to go for a web development career track, you have to learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. These are called Holy Trinity of web development, and you have to have a good understanding of these three. Then you can learn any JavaScript framework such as React.js or Vue.js or Node.js. These are very popular frameworks which allows you to do web development very fast. If you decide to become a mobile app developer, then again, you need to have a good understanding of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. But for mobile app development, you can now do either a native mobile app development or a hybrid. In the native, for iOS, there is a Swift programming language that you need to learn. If you decide to go with Android, then you need to learn Java. For hybrid, you need to learn frameworks such as React Native. There is a Flutter from Google. There are so many frameworks, but React Native from Facebook is very popular nowadays. If you decide to do backend programming and numerical computing, data science, etc., Python is the language to go for. The good thing about Python is it can be used as a full stack development language, where if you want to do, let's say, web development, then you can use Django framework, which is written in Python. For doing machine learning, AI, numerical computing, there are so many libraries available in Python. You can also learn Java for backend programming. If you are doing something like big data computing, then there Java is very popular. Step number 5 is to start level 1 programming tutorials. Here is the stage where you are getting your hands dirty and you are writing your first program. The idea here is, at this stage of your programming journey, you want to get basic understanding of writing code, such as using variables, data types, how to run your code, basic file operations, etc. If you have chosen a web and mobile app development career track, you can follow HTML, CSS, and JavaScript tutorials from Khan Academy. So the good thing about Khan Academy is, first of all, it is free. The tutorials are explained in a very simple language, and there are exercises and quizzes. There is another great resource called Code Academy. On Code Academy, you can create a free account, which allows you to watch 180 hours of content per month. Of course, you will not get access to some of the premium features, but let's say if you can afford money, you can go for the pro account. Just a little disclaimer, by the way, none of the online courses that I'm mentioning in this video are sponsored. This is based on my own research and my opinion. The way Code Academy works is a little different. They will be very, very interactive. They will ask you to write code from the very first step. So watch those online courses on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Some of them are free, okay, and some of them require pro account. So whatever I am linking in the video description below, those are all the free courses. So all you need to do is just create an account and start following those courses. If you decide to pursue data analyst, data science, scientist type of career track, and let's say if you want to learn Python, then I have a nice Python tutorial playlist, which I have designed for, let's say, you know, high schoolers. Even a high school student can understand these tutorials really well. In this playlist, I recommend you watch first 14 tutorials only, because at this stage, you want to just get basic understanding. And after that, there will be some steps you'll be following, and then you can watch remaining tutorials. Python is a great language if you are just beginning your coding journey, right? If you're not sure which programming language I want to learn, I would say just go for Python, because Python is very, very easy to learn. It's like English-like. It's so easy that even a high school student can learn it easy. For Python tutorials, I also have Hindi tutorials. So if you're not comfortable with English and if you want to watch them in Hindi, I have a separate Hindi channel where you can watch those Hindi tutorials. The exercises in Hindi tutorials are much better, actually. So even if you're doing English tutorials, I will say do the exercises from my Hindi tutorials, and I'm gonna provide my GitHub link where you can get access of all the exercises, and there is a link to all the solutions as well. All right, now you have completed level 1 coding tutorials, you have some understanding of how to write code and run it, etc. At this stage, you should now learn debugging skills. Debugging skills is extremely important if you want to become a good programmer. For this also, I have a complete playlist. I have 3 tutorials where I have explained how you can debug the code in PyCharm code editor. You can use the concepts in this tutorials for pretty much any code editor, be it Visual Studio Code or even Eclipse, any IDE. IDE is basically integrated development environment, or your code editor where you are writing your code. Now thinking about code editor, Visual Studio Code today as of 2020 is the most popular IDE. So if you're confused on which code editor to choose, just go for Visual Studio Code, because you can do JavaScript programming, Python programming, any type of programming in that. For Python specifically, there is PyCharm Community Edition that is freely available to download from JetBrains website. So you can use PyCharm as well, but that will be more for Python. I have this another great tutorial link for how to do debugging in Chrome. If you are doing web programming, you will be doing debugging in Chrome or any other browser. For that, the good thing is browsers have inbuilt a code debugger which you can use. You can set a breakpoint, you can execute your code, you can step through, step in your code, etc. This tutorial is from Google, so please watch it. Again, let me remind you, having good debugging skills is extremely important, especially in your early phase, because early phase, what will happen is you will write code and it will give the output that you are not expecting. And you will be wondering why this is happening. At that time, you can debug your code step by step and you can know what's going on inside your code. Step number 7 is data structures. Guys, data structure is extremely important. There is not a single programming interview that I have seen in my life where they don't ask about data structures. Data structures are basic building blocks of any program. Doesn't matter which programming language you are using, Java, Python, whatever it is, you will be using data structure for sure. For that also, I have another tutorial playlist, so go watch that. Once you have sound understanding of data structures, you can be a really good programmer. And these tutorials have exercises as well, so remember the fundamentals of effective learning, which is watching less tutorials and practicing more, okay? So even after you watch those data structure tutorials, make sure you practice all the exercises that I have given, and I have the solution of those exercises on my GitHub page as well. After that, the next step is to learn SQL. If you want to become a good programmer, you need to have sound understanding of SQL. Okay, even for a data scientist or data analyst, SQL is a must. For that, I have a link of a Khan Academy course on SQL. This course again is very, very basic. You are just starting on SQL for the first time and it will walk you through all the basic concepts like relational databases, the primary key, foreign key, the joins between the tables, etc. There is a great playlist on YouTube by Kuda Venkat on SQL. Now this playlist contains lots of videos. I would suggest you watch only first 12 videos for the basics. Now if you are interested in gaining additional skills in SQL, you can watch remaining tutorials. Step number 9 is level 2 programming tutorials. So at this stage, you have done some basic programming, you know how to do debugging, you have good understanding of data structures, SQL, etc. Now you are ready for level 2 or intermediate programming tutorial. On Python programming playlist, now you can watch the tutorial number 15 onwards on my channel, because that will be little advanced. If you are doing web programming, then I have a link of Khan Academy courses. I have two courses here. One is to how to do dynamic web pages and how to do jQuery. Step number 10 is to learn about algorithms. Algorithms are again a very important concept other than data structure, and it applies to any programming language that you are learning. For this, I have a Khan Academy course link where you know you go over basic algorithms like binary search and merge sort and different types of sort mechanisms and all of that. This way you get good understanding of inner workings of your program, how your program performs, the big O complexity, and so on. So any good programmer will have sound understanding of algorithm. After you are done with this step, The next step would be to start working on projects. Now, until now, whatever steps you followed, you can do project-based learning, or I call it like a targeted learning. And what I mean by that is, whenever you're learning, let's say level 1 coding tutorials or level 2 coding tutorials, you need to have a concrete project in mind that you're working on. Let's say you are doing web development. In that case, you should target to finish one simple website at least. And that is your target. Now, to finish that target, you are learning all these different concepts such as HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, right? After you have followed all these steps, now your goal should be to work on more and more projects, okay? So if you are a web developer, initially you build, let's say, static website. Now you build dynamic website, you build an e-commerce website. Similarly for Python, you wrote simple program which will do some simple file manipulation. Now you write programs that can do, let's say, data visualization, for example. Now if you want to do data visualization, you need to learn Matplotlib or let's say seaborn library, and now you can go and watch Matplotlib tutorials or seaborn tutorials. If you're doing numeric computing, you will watch NumPy tutorials. Let's say you pick a project for machine learning. In that case, you can watch now machine learning tutorials. So see, after following this first 10 steps, now your learning train is kind of on the track and it has started accelerating. So now what you're doing is you are working on more and more projects, and to finish particular projects, whatever new skills you require, you learn them on demand. Okay, as in when there is a need, you now learn new skills such as NumPy, sklearn, seaborn, and so on. And as you practice more and more projects, you will become more and more better at programming. So this diagram highlights the 11 steps approach, where you begin as a zero and then become hero in programming. I want to repeat this again, that anyone can learn coding. You don't need to have computer science background. You don't need to be genius. Nowadays, all these programming languages, Python, JavaScript, etc., they are high level programming languages and they are very easy to code. Like here, I live in US, and here they teach these programming languages in the middle school, and middle schooler can also do programming really well. I was going to a library to teach programming, and there was like 8 year old kid, and he was very good in programming. Okay, so just keep this in mind that you can also do it. All you need to do is follow a disciplined approach and follow the approach which gives you maximum ROI, which is your return on investment. Okay, so if you follow this 11 step approach, you will spend minimum time and get the maximum output for your effort. And programming is something that is nowadays required in any field. Doesn't matter what your profession is. If you are a mechanical engineer, electrical engineer, even in HR, if you have programming skills, then that will separate you out from the crowd, okay? And you can get better job. You can make a fast progress in your career. Also, if you want to switch a career, let's say you want to go in data science or programming, having these skills will really help you to make a transition in that field. And being a programmer has so many benefits. For example, right now we are in coronavirus era where we are in a lockdown. But if you're a programmer, most likely you're not going to lose your job. You can work from home. All you need is internet connection. Also, programmer gets paid really high. Okay, so financial reward is also amazing. And the future is also very bright for programmers.
I have created a GitHub page with all the information that I discussed in this video, along with the links of all the courses. So you can see that there are links of all the courses here. And whatever I describe in the video is available in a text form. So the link of this GitHub MD page is available in video description. So please check the video description, go to this link and explore all the useful links that I have given here.
So that's all I had for this video. I hope it clears some confusion in case you are confused about where to begin. And if you have any question, please post in the comment below. I try to answer as many comments as possible. So any confusion, don't hesitate. No question is a stupid question. You can ask the question in the